Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we gonna discuss one more interview question, that is print only prime numbers. So what is prime numbers? So those numbers which is going to divide by 1 or itself. So those numbers are prime numbers. So here as we can see we have 2, 3, 5, 7, 11. So these are the numbers which will be divided by 1 or itself. So we need to write a query to print the prime numbers between 1 to 50. So how we can write the query for printing the prime numbers between 1 to 50? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio where we can write the query. So here I am using SQL 2017. You may have an other versions of SQL Server. So here, so first of all, I need to declare a variable. So declare @i and this should be integer type. And this is 2. So initial value would be 2. Then we need to declare one more variable, that would be checking for prime. So we can say this is prime and integer, initial value should be 0. Next we need to declare our output table. So declare @output and this is table type, and it would have only one column, that would be number, and it will be going to hold only prime numbers. Then our logic will be started. So here, first of all, we need to use a loop. So we can set up while loop. If this @i value is less than or equals to 50, because we want to print prime numbers between 1 to 50. If we want to print the prime numbers between 1 to 100, then we can replace this 50 by 100. Then begin and. So between this begin and, we need to declare one more variable to check about the prime numbers, and we can call this as j, and this would be integer type as well. And here we need to initialize the value of this @i. So @i minus 1, because it will be going to check one by one. If we have 5, then initial value for this @j would be 4. Then we need to check up for 4, 3, 2, 1. If that value will be divided between these numbers, then that is not prime number. So next we can set our flag, that is prime equals to 1. Now we need to use one more loop. So here we can set up for while @j value is greater than 1, then begin, then and. And between this begin and, we can write the logic. So logic would be very simple. Here we can check if @i value modulus with the @j value equals to 0, then we can say that number is not a prime number. Then we can set the value for this @prime variable would be 0. After this if, we need to increase the value of this @j variable will be @j plus 1. After this if condition, we need to decrease the value of this @j variable would be minus 1. So @j minus 1. After this inner while loop, we need to check if @prime is equals to 1. It means that number is prime number. So we can use the begin, then and. And here we need to insert that value into the output table. So this is the output table, and we can call this as values, and here we can say @i. Now looks good. After this if, we just need to increase the value of @i variable. So @i plus 1. Now looks good. Now we can select and we can check. So select asterisk from our output. Now we can execute. So here we are getting the output like 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23. So these are the values which we are expecting. If we want to print prime numbers between 1 to 100, then 50 will be replaced by 100. Now here we can check, we are getting the prime numbers between 1 to 100. So here, this is very simple. We have initialized a variable like @i with the value of 2. Then we have set up a flag for prime initial value is 0. Then we have declared a output table. Then we have started a loop because here we have value with 2 and we want to print the prime numbers between 1 to 100. So that's why we have used this while loop. After that, here we have set up a @j variable and initial value of this @j variable will be @i minus 1, because if we will have @i value will be 2, then this @j will be 1 and we can set flag that is @prime will be 1. And here we have loop, so first @j will be greater than 1, so our condition will not be satisfied, so it will be directly moved to if condition. And here we can see it's a prime number, so we can insert that value. Next time, once this @i value will be increased by 3, so it would be, so 3 is less than 100, then go inside this. And here we can check @j value, that would be 2. So we can set @prime flag will be 1. Then here we can see we have a while loop and this while loop will be going to satisfy the condition because @j value is 2. Then go inside @i that is 3. So here 3 mod 2 that will not be going to 0. This if condition will be skipped and @j value will be decreased by 1. Next time that would be 1. So this while loop will not be executed because condition will not be satisfied and this @i value will be increased. So this @i value will be increased by 4. So here this loop will be satisfied the condition. So here @j value will be 3. We can set flag prime for 1. Then this loop will be executed because 4 is greater than 1. And here it will be going to check if mod of 4 with 3. So this will not be satisfied. So @j value will be decreased by 1. So next time that value will be 2. So here while condition it will be going to check the condition that is satisfied. Then @i value will be 4 and @j value will be 2. So this condition will be satisfied this time. Then @prime value will be set to 0. So here just skip this loop and here we can see @prime value that is not is equals to 1, so that value will not be inserted in the output and this loop will be executed until our condition will be satisfied. So I hope you have understand how we can write the query to print the prime numbers. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. If you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.